Welcome back, students. My name is Dolan Banerjee, and we were discussing about the geotechnical engineering. This is the continuation of the video series which is conducted by the AKTU. So let us continue with our chapter today. In the last class, we have just seen the assumptions of the Terzaghi's theory. Today we will be dealing with the coefficient of consolidation. Okay, what is the coefficient of consolidation? It is actually the CV. Okay, so we will be going through the determination of coefficient of consolidation, how we will be determining the coefficient of consolidation, which is written as CV. Okay. So, first of all, what is over consolidation pressure? Actually, maximum pressure to which an over consolidated soil had been subjected in the past is known as pre-consolidation or over consolidation pressure. When a soil specimen is taken from natural deposit, the weight of the overlaying material is removed. This causes expansion of the soil due to reduction in the pressure. You know that yesterday we discussed about the over consolidated soil. What is over consolidated soil? Over consolidated soil are actually those soil which has already experienced a higher pressure than that which it's experiencing in the today's date. Okay, so which means in the past it was, we can take an example such as in the past perhaps it might have taken pressure of 100 kilonewton per meter square, but in today's date if we measure the pressure there, then we find that it's only 20 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, so hence this soil will be said to be over consolidated. Okay, over consolidated. Okay, so here the over consolidation pressure, what will be the over consolidation pressure? It is just the pressure or maximum pressure which the soil had experienced in the past. Okay, just that amount of pressure which it had experienced in the past, due to which it has now become the over consolidated soil. Okay, so talking about the field condition, when the soil is taken out from the natural deposit, what happens? Suppose this is your ground, some soil was here. Okay, now this soil, when we dig it out, okay, something like this, okay, then this much soil pressure, the soil is here also, as we know, in the ground. So this much soil pressure, okay, soil pressure, or we can say it as overburden pressure, now has got reduced as soon as we take it out. Now, as this pressure has reduced, what will happen? This soil will tend to expand. Okay, it will try to expand to a level. Okay, so let us move forward. The specimen is generally pre-consolidated or over-consolidated when the specimen is loaded in the consolidation test. The initial portion, okay, first of all understand this much. What it is saying, that now as we have already talked that this specimen which we have taken out or dug out from the ground, this is trying to expand now, or we can say that this much of the overburden pressure has been removed from it. What does this mean? This is the same condition, you can see. Some higher pressure was being applied before some time. Now, after we dug it out or we take out from the ground, then now the pressure on it has increased very considerably. Okay, so, but this soil will be categorized as over consolidated only, because first of all it was experiencing a higher pressure, now it is experiencing a lower pressure. Okay, so this is a over consolidated soil. So we can say in general we get an over consolidated soil only. Okay, with the specimen which we use in the consolidation test is actually over consolidated or pre-consolidated. Now we are going to the graph. The initial portion AB of the compression curve ABCD is the recompression curve. Let us see the graph. This one, this part is, now this is the graph obtained from consolidation test. okay. This is obtained from consolidation test. Later on, using the Casagrande method, we will be finding out some more parameters from the graph, but this graph, this curve is actually obtained from the consolidation test only. Okay. So, you can see what is it, there is a log P and E, means we have two parameters, one is E and one is log P bar. What is this? This is the effective stress. Okay, this is the effective stress. So, let us go back. So, this part is actually a recompression curve. Why? Because just now I told you that the soil obtained in the ground is soil obtained as specimen from the ground is over consolidated. Okay, is over consolidated, which means it is a recompression curve. So, what else it is saying? So, AV, now we have understood what is it and why it is flat. Okay, now followed by a straight line CD with a steep slope, which indicates the compression in the virgin or normally consolidated soil. Okay, in the transition range BC, the slope gradually changes, the pre-consolidation pressure falls in this range. What is it saying actually? You can see here, this was a recompression curve. From here till here, we can say that now this is the normally consolidated soil or normally consolidated clay. Okay, anyone may be the case. So, you, if you remember, for this type of soil, okay, what do we call this curve? This is called as virgin curve. Okay, this is the virgin curve. So, this part BE2D will be called as a virgin compression curve or virgin curve simply. And you can see this is a flatter part, AB is a flatter part. You can see here this part is much flatter. Now, you can see the curvature has changed or increased very quickly. Okay. So, we can say that actually AB is for recompression, and after that this all will be for the normally consolidated from here till here. Okay. So, this was it about the graph. Now, let us see what is actually Casagrande method, why is it used. Actually, the Casagrande method will be used to find out the pre-consolidation pressure. Okay. The main motive is to find out the pre-consolidation pressure, which is this one. Okay. So, what we will do, just I will first of all tell you, okay, then we can go through the lines. What we will do first of all, we know that just now I told you that the curvature has increased from B to D. So, we will just find out the point of maximum curvature. Okay. In this case, we can say that E has the maximum curvature. Okay. Maximum curvature means radius of curvature is maximum. Okay. Maximum radius of curvature, okay, which is E point here. Okay, this one. Here what we will do, we will draw a tangent, we will draw a tangent something like this. Okay, EF is the tangent, you can see. Now, once the tangent is drawn at the same point E, what we will do, we will draw a horizontal line. This is the horizontal line. Okay, this will be EG. Now, once these two lines are drawn, we will find the bisector of this whole angle. Now, you can see that this is an angle. Okay. So, we will find the bisector of this angle. So, the bisector of this angle will be EH. Okay. This is will be equal to this. Okay. This is the bisector now. So, what have we done? We have find out the tangent, then the horizontal line, then the bisector. Okay. So, all three will be passing from the point E only. Okay. So, this was the initial part. Now, let us go to the lines. determine the point E on the curve which has the maximum curvature, as I have already told you, okay. Then draw the tangent EF to the curve E. What will be the EF? This will be the tangent. Then a horizontal line EG at E again, okay. We have done already this part. Bisect the angle between the tangent EF and horizontal EH with the bisector, that will be EH, okay. EG with EH, okay. This also we have already done. Now produce back the straight line CD of the curve and determine the point of intersection P of the bisector EH and backward extension of the CD. What does this mean? We have to produce the curve backward, okay. We have to produce the straight line CD of the curve. So if we see the curve, this is your curve, okay. We are to produce this. This was the curve, so we produce like this. We have produced it like something like this, okay. So that it cuts a point at EH line. We produced it something like this so that we get a point this, okay, on the EH line, on EH line, okay. So once this point is obtained, this will be named as P, okay. We have got the point P on the bisector EH, okay, and the backward extension of CD. So we have extended it backward and found at the point P. Now we don't have to do anything, we will have just to extend it to the x axis. The point where it meets will give us log P C, which will be something value, say x. So this will be equal to 10 to the power x, because we are, this is a base 10, okay. So from here we will get the value of PC or pre-consolidation pressure. You can see, draw the vertical PJ through the point P which cuts at this. This point will be give us the pre-consolidation pressure, okay. So like this we will finally find out the pre-consolidation pressure. Now we will go into the determination of coefficient of consolidation. What is coefficient of consolidation? This is the CV, okay, CV. Actually, this parameter was introduced by Terzaghi. Okay, this parameter was introduced by Terzaghi in his theory of consolidation. In his theory of consolidation. Now let us see. By applying a series of load increments to the soil sample and recording settlement at selected time interval, the consolidation test proceeds. Observations of the compression versus time for each load interval are taken and the data are plotted on the semi-logarithmic plot or square root. Actually, you know the consolidation, as I have already discussed yesterday or in the last class, what that we will be finding out the time and settlement in mm, okay, settlement. These two parameters we will be finding out, okay. And to find out the settlement, what we do, we increase the stress, okay. Stress increment is done. Stress increment is done, okay. And after the stress increment, what we do, we leave it the specimen stressed at that particular stress for a prolonged time so that its total settlement can be calculated at different time intervals. We already talked about this in the last slide. So from this whole exercise we obtain a curve, okay, we obtain the curve. So that curve will be used to find out the value of CV. Now how will that curve be used? It will be modified in a way so that we can use the curve to find out the value of CV. So generally there are two main methods for this. One is the square root of time fitting method, another is the logarithmic of time fitting method, okay. By name you can understand this is square root of time and this is logarithmic of time. So for this we will be using under root t, okay, under root t, and for this we will be using log t. Okay, so let us go through the procedure so that we can understand how we will be calculating this CV. First of all, square root of time fitting method, or it is also called Taylor's method. This method was obviously developed by Taylor's, okay, utilizes the theoretical relation between under root t and u. What is u? It is the degree of consolidation, which we already have talked about. The relationship is linear up to a level where u becomes equal to 60. It was observed that at 90%, the value of this is 1.5 means 15% more than, okay, 15% more than the general value. Okay, a curve is plotted from consolidation test results between the dial gauge readings and the under root t value. Means generally what we were doing, we were calculating the dial gauge readings, okay, this was the dial gauge readings. Okay, with t only. But now what we'll do? We'll modify it and make it under root t, and dial gauge reading will be here. So, okay. Then what we will do? The line obtained by joining the initial point is extended. Okay, and 15% larger is located. Abscissa will be means. The curve comes to be something like this, then this is something like this, okay, it will meet here somewhere. We extend it by 15% so that it goes and meets somewhere like this, okay. This is our exercise which we will be doing. This straight portion is produced backward to intersect the ordinate at R naught, which will be 0 reading, okay, for u equals to 0. Get R naught and B in the second line drawn. From there, we will find the T90. Let us see here. This was the original curve. This was the original curve. Okay. This was produced back. Okay. First of all, produced back and produced front to get a straight line. Okay. We got this straight line now. Increase by 15%. Increase this line by 15%. Then produce it. Then we will be getting this line. This is the point B, okay. This is the point B, and here you can see that we have produced this to get the R naught, okay. R naught is somewhere here, B point is here. This is the 1.15 A line, okay. This is the 1.15 A line. So now you can see that we have obtained, this was the T100 here somewhere, okay. This was the T100. Now, after producing, we cut this line here. The initial curve is cut where? By this produced line or increased line, somewhere here. So, this will give you the R90, and corresponding to this somewhere here, you will get the T90. Okay. And in this method, in this square root of time fitting, we actually are concerned. Are concerned with finding out T90. Okay, T90. So by this method we have found out. I'll summarize you again here. This was the initial curve which we had obtained. Okay, by the test results. Now what we will be doing? We will first produce it. Let us make something, we will produce it like this, it will go through this, and a straight line is this one, okay. Thus, we have produced it in the both directions. Now, 15 time increment is done. So, let us say something like this, a line will be obtained, okay. A line again is obtained. If this was A, this will be 1.15 A. This point, we can say this point is B, okay. So, now this point where, okay, this point where it is bisecting the initial curve, this will give you R90, means reading for 90, and for corresponding T90 will be here, okay. Now, what is this 90 actually? What is this 90 here? This is the U, means U should be 90%. Or we can say T90 is actually time required for 90% consolidation. Okay, this is the 90% consolidation T90. Again, similarly, what will be the R90? R90, this will be the mm or reading corresponding to 90% consolidation. Okay, so this was the final thing. So we found out according to the T90. Okay, this is it. Now you can see in this case is an example, what we find that the T90 comes to be 3040. Okay. Sorry, R90, and T90 comes to be somewhere here. So less than 5, it is taken as 4.95. As it is a under root plot, under root T, this is a under root T plot. So T will be 4.95 square. Okay. So this is the value which comes out to be this much. Now what is this? Let me clear all. How is this calculated? What is this? If you remember, there is a formula TV is equals to CV into T upon D square, or sometimes also written as H square. Okay. If you don't know this formula, please remember it. Just it will be encountered afterwards also in the same slide. Here, TV is the time factor. Time factor depends on degree of consolidation. Okay, depends upon the degree of consolidation. Is it fine? So means T will be directly depending upon U. Okay, how much percentage has been consolidated? In this case, 90%. Okay. So TV corresponding to 90% is actually 0.848. We will see the formula later on. Okay, so this 848 from there only. Besides this T90, okay, for this case it will be 90 only. So this 90 is obtained from here, which is 24.5. So to calculate CV, it will be TV into D square upon T90. Okay, so this is calculated as 24.5 minutes. Okay, so this is here. This I told you 0.848, and just for the practical purpose, in this case we have taken the thickness of the specimen to be how much? 2 centimeters. Okay, and a double drainage condition, you know. Two centimeter is D, and double drainage. So D becomes 1 centimeter. Okay, that is how 2 by 2, 2 centimeter by 2. Okay, so this is converted into meter, so it becomes 0.01 meter. This value is kept here, and this final answer for CV is obtained. This is just an example. Okay, so let us move forward. All these parameters we will be just studying about. Okay, don't worry about this TV and how this D, what is double drainage and all, and how is this T. This is already I think you have understood. Okay, now logarithmic of time fitting method. One was the square root method, now logarithmic method. This was developed by A. Casagrande. Determines 100% U on the semi log plot of the laboratory time consolidation curve by theoretical curve U and log TV. Okay, first of all, a t1 time is selected in the initial portion of the curve, okay, in the parabolic part. Then our t2 time is selected, which is 4 times of t1 in this parabolic portion again, okay. Now, after that, the ordinate or the offset between them is calculated, and this offset again further helps us to find the r0. Then r100, this is r0, okay, r0 corresponding to u, okay, this is u is 0%. Then r100 value is obtained by intersection of tangent between the mid curve, okay, and after that mean is taken to find the r50. In this case, remember, we find t50. Our motive is to find, t50, okay, not t90 as in the last case. So, how we will be doing, let us see. First of all, you have been given this curve, okay, you have this curve from the tests, okay, in the lab. Now, what we will do, we will take t1 somewhere here, and corresponding to this, we will get the r0 value, where it is intersecting, this value gives the r0 value, okay, this t1 in the initial parabolic part. Then 4 times of t1, that is t2, somewhere here, okay, this is your 4 times of t1 t2, okay, corresponding to this, okay, we will come to that later on. First of all, after that we have find the t2. Now what we do, from here draw a tangent here, and again from this straight portion draw a tangent, from this straight draw again tangent, again from here, okay, two tangents from this part and from this part. The intersection, the intersection of these tangents when produced will give you the r100 value, okay, r100 value. So, the mean of these two value will be given by this, okay. So, this is just easy like this, this is nothing such tough in this. So, r50, how is it obtained? Mean of these two. Again, remember t1 is taken by choice and corresponding r0 is obtained. After that, we produce the tangent in both parts and get the r100 value, take the mean of this to get the r50 value, okay. Then t50 will be corresponding to this only, this is your t50, okay, this is your t50 value, and t2 is this line only, here t2 is this line, and this is your t50 value, okay. Again, CV, how it is calculated, the same formula, but this time you can see this is same, this t50 is here, this value is changed. What was this value? This was tv. Tv for 50% will be 0.197. So, this is kept here. Just calculate it to get this CV, okay. Now, CV determination, this was the formula I was talking about, CV is equals to TV into H square upon TI, okay. The T50 and T90 values are used to compute the coefficient of consolidation by this formula, where this is the time factor, this is the length of the drainage path, you can also represent sometime it by D, okay. It is half when the drainage face is from both sides, we will see how it is half. Then TI is the time, okay. Now, you can see, I already told you that for 50% it is 0.198 and for 90% it is 0.848. So, these values come out to be, okay. So, from here, just replace the values of TV in this to get these values, okay. So, this was it in this PPT. We will go and continue about in detail about what is TV and how we will be calculating the D and what is double drainage and all in the next class of the geotechnical engineering lecture series. Please be connected. Thank you.